Hello, and welcome to McClendon Studios. I'm your host, David E. McClendon, Sr. And today we're going to review the book, Personal Finance for Dummies. Now, this book is probably rates about a 4.5. The only couple of minor problems. Now, it is well written, with one exception. It is well researched. And so I just have a very few problems with it. And that problem stems from the fact that I was educated with a teacher, Mrs. Ruth Elrod, my English teacher, many, many years ago. And she and several of my other English professors and English teachers have pointed out that anytime you use the word whether, as in, I don't know whether I'm going to the fair or not, I don't know whether it's raining outside or not, there's always an opposite side to weather. So you don't say, I don't know whether it's raining outside. You say, I don't know whether it's raining outside or not. Now, this is a very minor point, so it shouldn't really subtract much from the overall reading of the book, unless you are very particular about your grammar. And this is a very minute point. And it's one of the few negatives I can find in the book. The other one is a little more important, and that's where, on a couple of occasions in the book, he states that it's not so important to balance your checkbook very often, and it's not so important to balance it to the very last penny. Now, that may be true if you have a large bank account, you have a lot of money going in and coming out, and you maintain large balances. So it may be true in that case. But in the case of we're down here, down at this level of poor, which is part of the premise of the poor redneck, you're very, very poor. You don't have that extra few cents to worry about. You don't have that. And what I found in balancing our checkbook, and I balance it every couple of days by going online and checking it, comparing it with the bank, and making sure that everything has cleared like the way it's supposed to, and that the balance is my balance matches the bank's balance. What I have found is very often there are minor mistakes that could add up overall to cause me to bounce a debit. Now, when you're down at this level of poor, having an overdraft is a very serious situation because one overdraft causes another. It's the whole domino effect. And so I differ on that with Mr. Tyson here. Eric Tyson wrote the book. I differ with him on that. Other than that, everything else seems to be spot on and pretty much accurate. If you have hundreds of thousands of dollars in your bank account, then that's not important. And the book isn't written for people on the very poor level. They can use it, but it's not written for the people on this very, very poor level. Because he's talking more about investments and that type of thing, which you wouldn't have at this very, very poor level. Once you rise up in income, then this book would come in handy. But for right now, if we're talking about the very, very poor level, where you have to save up to buy a bottle of Coke, or Diet Coke, as my case is, then the book isn't exactly for you just yet, but it will be, and it's good to have this information. Thank you for taking the time to listen to me. If you're watching this on the blog site, you can find links to the book and other things below. If you're watching it on Amazon.com, please let Amazon know that this has been a useful video, if it has been. Thank you very much. This is a Federal Trade Commission required notice. When you click on an advertisement that is displayed with this video, or just before it, we receive a small commission. Sometimes, if you merely watch an ad, we receive commission. If you purchase anything by clicking on links on any of our websites, we receive a commission as well. These great redneck coffee mugs are available at www.cafepress.com/redneckforpresident. We receive a commission off of them as well. You can also purchase buttons, yard signs, etc. from that website.